Hi everyone and welcome to Exclusively Equine Veterinary Services. Today I'm answering a question regarding gastric ulcers, how you know if your horse has them, how to diagnose them and how to treat. It's an interesting question we have because the lady who asked this question actually has a beautiful shiny horse but he's grumpy. And it's very common for people to have fat, healthy horses that have ulcers. So ulcers is a sign of stress. So you can have a beautiful show horse and majority of racehorses, up to 80% of racehorses have ulcers. And those things are, you know, elite athletes and they look beautiful, but they can have ulcers. So ulcers are related to stress, not condition and feeding. So you can have an emaciated horse with no ulcers, or you can have a fat, shiny show pony with ulcers. Lots of signs that can indicate potentially that your horse has ulcers is varied. So you can have a horse that doesn't like being girthed up. You can have a horse that puts their ears back when you look at going to feed them. You can have a horse that will look at their feed, walk away from it and show a few colic signs. They can show just grumpiness generally. There's lots of varied signs, but a horse that has no signs can still have ulcers. So the only way to diagnose properly that your horse has ulcers is by an endoscope. So popping a camera down their esophagus and into their stomach. That's the only way to properly diagnose ulcers. You can have a blood test done to see if there's any indications that there could be ulcers, but the true way to diagnose ulcers is by an endoscope or a gastroscope. The thing with ulcers is there's a few parts in the stomach, the digestive tract, that a horse can have ulcers, and it really depends where the ulcers are as to the best treatment required. So we highly recommend a gastroscope to diagnose the ulcers are there and also to grade them, because your horse could have mild ulcers or it could have severe ulcers. And depending on whether they're mild or severe depends on how long you have to treat. For a mild case, you only have to treat for 14 days, but if they're severe, sometimes up to 42 days to treat. So a lot of people will just go ahead and treat their horses for ulcers even if they're not diagnosed, which is okay. But you don't know whether you have to treat for 14 or 42 days. And there's a big price difference as to whether you're treating for 14 days or 42 days. The other thing that you have to be aware of is if your horse has ulcers in the hind part of the stomach, you have to help the drugs get to the hind part of the stomach. So you have to add a few other products to allow the drugs to be able to get to the area that they need to treat. So it is best to get your horse gastroscoped, because if you only treat 80% of the ulcers and leave 20% there, you're not going to clear the product, the ulcers up, the problem up. There's a lot of natural products on the market which are great for preventing them, but if you have ulcers, the only product is an omeprazole product that will treat the ulcers. Thanks so much, guys. Bye.